Oh God. That's right. I went grocery shopping. And this is what I got. Let's talk about this. What do Tilipe eat in order to stay fit? Let me close the door and we get to that point.
Alright. Check my phone real quick.
Alright, boom. What do Tilipe eat in order to stay fit? By the way, let me show the six pack before we even start. Alright. Boom. Boom. Okay. Okay. The six pack's in place. Okay. So let's get to the point and try to figure out. Okay. Alright. What do Tilipe eat the most? The protein, the carbs, whatever we want to talk about, right? It's just a simple thing, okay? Yeah, we're just doing some little thing here and there just to have fun, right? Boom, I'm no professional or all that, but hey, look Jack, right? Look Jack, right? Look. Alright, bro, let's get to it, alright? I'm gonna put all this down. Go one by one. Alright, boom, we're gonna start with
a little trash!
Alright, boom. Give the microphone close. Get to it, man. You better put a like on this video right now. I just fucked up my finger. Like, what the hell is going on? I just fucked up my finger. You put a like right now. I'm about to shoot everybody right now. I'm about to, you know what I'm saying? Like, turn on the like. I don't know what the hell I'm doing. Alright, let's get to the point. What do Tilipe eat in order to stay fit? Alright, boom. Let's see this thing right here, the main witch, right? I love to have this main witch right here mixed with this guy. For some reason, I like to put protein on top of protein and just, you know, mix this stuff.
What?
And I have enough protein in my system. It's simple as that. Okay?
I don't even know what that means.
So I don't have a lot of gram of protein in this. It's like one. And all that. Jesus Christ, I'm struggling for my meal. I don't need this. I don't need him. Alright, boom. So let's get to it. So this is what I got right here. Sweet peas, whatever you call it. Beans. Green beans. Boom. This bowl right here, I love to eat these things. Not because I love it, because there is a lot of protein in there. Not really too much protein in there, but look, I don't have to cook meat, right? I don't have to go ahead and cook a whole chicken in order to have some protein. This thing right here, I can just open like this right here. Me, I don't care about taste. So I can just open this and start eating this like right there, and I'm getting like 3 grams of protein, right? Boom. Two of them, 6 grams of protein. Boom. Let's put some eggs on top of it. Wait a minute. If you go ahead, right, and you get some eggs, and you Google online right now. Oh, I don't know why my computer is not on. Nonsense. I need to get smarter about all these things. If you go online right now, right, and you take the time to Google how many protein, okay, in an egg, okay? So now let's do the calculation right here. Boom. If this guy right here by himself got 6 grams protein, right? Boom. By itself, get 3 grams of protein. Boom. I'm talking about what? 9 grams of protein right now. Right? This 9 right here. Now, let's say I say 6. Let's say I'm the type of guy. I'm gonna go 4 to 5 eggs for no reason. 3, this is 4, 5. Now, 5 times 6. Wait a minute. Make sure I cut this in the video because God. Alright, so when you come back to everything.
5 times 6 is 30. I'm so ashamed. I had to use a calculator for it. It's the 21st century, 2020. We don't do calculation that way ahead anymore.
Alright, so let's get to the point. Boom. 5x. Right? 5 eggs, I'm getting 30 grams of protein. Plus this one right here. Let's say I put 2 of them, boom, in a plate. I'm eating good. I have a whole meal of 36 grams of protein. Alright? This might be 1 scoop. I don't know if it's 1 scoop when you take your whole protein galloon or whatever people buying the pork protein powder. But with this food right here, and it's that cheap. This is like 0.99. You know what I'm saying? 0.99. This is like, it's an egg. It's like 169 or something, or maybe 2, I don't know, whatever it is. With less than $5, I can basically have that much protein going on for me in my food. You follow me? And this thing, I can throw this in any type of food that I'm actually cooking. This is just something raw that I was just showing you, like. And this, I can just drink this like this, like that. You follow me? So this one. So I'm getting some eggs right here. Boom. I got my protein in there. I'm adding some beans on top of it. That's something. That this is a bit of sauce for the seasoning or whatever. You can use whatever you want. I'm not pretty smart at cooking, so that's the only thing that I know that somebody showed me, and I kept doing this forever. I don't use protein powder, alright? I just don't use this anymore. I just cook some stuff that will give me all the ingredients that are already in this type of things. You follow me? So when you cook natural food and you sit and you eat, it's good for your body. Then just freaking put a lot of chemicals and powders and everything mixed into your system. But some people are different, you follow me? I'm looking like this, going natural on every freaking thing I'm doing. So I can show you how to do this too. The workout, I have an ab workout online right now. You gotta check this stuff out. And let's not make the video too long, so I'm about to go through all these chickens that I bought real quick. And we're moving on. Alright, boom. So here I got the meat. Yeah, I got the chicken breast, by the way. I never really cooked chicken breast in my life. It's because I couldn't find meat. I couldn't find meat out there. So I had to buy this. So I bought this for like what, 10 bucks? 10 bucks, this is 10 bucks. It's like by the pound. It's like 1.99 by the pound. So whatever, those are pretty big, I'm telling you. Those are pretty huge. It's gonna last me for a little while. I took like two huge ones. So yeah, chicken breast, man. I don't know how I'm gonna deal with this. Let me see how many protein we get into this too. You see, all I bought is full of protein, and it's natural food. You follow me? So how much protein we get in this one? Oh, we're gonna have to Google this stuff. No, we have it here. Calories 120. Many protein we got here, 24 grams of protein, you see? But you see, 24 grams of protein, maybe if I'm cooking like one of these, you follow me? One of these, I will get 24 grams of protein. But this egg already that I showed you, 5 eggs, with maybe 2 of these. 2 of these will give you 6 grams of protein. 5X is 5 times 6. You got 30. 36 gram of protein in your system already. You see, you don't need to eat everything and all of it. It's not hard to get fit. It's not hard to get the amount of protein that you need in order to be fit and stay fit and get and feed your muscle. It's not that hard. You see, I just show you some simple things right here. Now, if you put some seasoning and whatever you add and whatever you're doing, you know what I'm saying? It's gonna change things because I don't know how to cook. So I just take the damn thing like this and just throw it in my mouth. Man, I make sure I calculate the amount of protein that I put in my system. Now we better get to the carbs. All right. Let's see. You see, this thing got a lot of sodium in there. And sodium, they say, people say sodium, when there's a lot of sodium in there, it's a lot of water. And when it's a lot of water, it goes through your system, your guts don't come out and all of that. Well, this is for people who compete. People who actually compete, do competition, they need to get the water out of the system so that the skin can be straight, pasted to the muscles, so everything can be seen, even the nerves and all that stuff. Yeah, and it's kind of crazy, you know what I'm saying? So for days, sometimes don't even drink water in order to get ready for competition. You're not doing that. You're just trying to get some, you know, some shoulders thick, you know, some six pack, and get ready for the chicks, for the little girls out here, and look good. For yeah, you follow me? You ain't trying to compete and do all that. You see me out there trying to compete? I'm not doing all that, nigga. Look good. I'm be on camera. Start dancing for the ladies and shit. Start. That's what I'm trying to do. You follow me? So yeah. So boom. You get your food. Yeah, you get your food right here. Boom. You get this shit going. All right. So I got the meat right. That's a lot of meat, my man. That's a lot of meat. This like tomorrow and this week coming, I'ma be working out crazy, like, because I got a lot of protein going on. You follow me? When I don't got a lot of food in my fridge, I just don't go work out. Because when you work out, you make your muscle tired and your muscle start asking for, you know, for the substance, for protein, for carbs, for whatever it's asking for it. And now when you don't have it, it start eating himself. Oh, you're not even getting there. It start eating himself. The muscle eats itself, and you're losing muscle while you were trying to build muscle. The body is something else, man. I don't know how to explain this stuff. Let's get to the next one. Now, this is type of stuff I like to buy too, right? I bought a lot of this. A lot. This is the beef pork pie, whatever they call it. Lucky Chris, nah, I don't know what this thing is, bro, but it's good. It's good. It's like something already made, okay? So because I'm not that good at cooking, god damn it, I got powder coming out of this thing and all that. Man, that's the thing I don't like about all this food pre-make and all this stuff, man. But what we gonna do? We can't cook, so we gonna deal with it. You follow me? Put it in the microwave, 3 minutes, 4 minutes. It's already cooked. You get it out, boom, you start eating. You see, sometimes I'm gonna be into my workout, or I'm gonna be working or doing crazy stuff, and I don't have the time to actually cook and do things and come up with whatever, you know what I'm saying? So I just put one of those 3 minutes, throw it in there. My body's asking for whatever substance they need. Boom, I put it in my system. I'm moving. You follow me? So I've been getting. I'll be getting a good amount of those, and I'm going through the week or the month with this whenever I need. Okay. Whenever I need some more food in my system, whenever I need snacks, you see, when you need snacks and all those stupid stuff that make you eat the type of things that you don't want to eat, or eat the type of things that you're not supposed to eat. That's the time I just put one of those and just enjoy it. You follow me? And just enjoy it. Like, simple as that. I got this thing right here. Now let's see. This got 320 calories in there. Man, I don't really count calories. Yeah, I like to see the carbonitrate and all that. Yeah, carbonitrate, you got 31 gram of carbonitrate. Meaning, if you get before your workout, those getaway, whatever they call it, those drinks, how much of carbs they got in there? Carbs in a getaway. Getaway. Oh my God. Getaway. You see, total carbohydrate in the getaway, those drinks that you buy and all that, 14 gram of carbohydrate in there. And you know carbohydrate helps you when you do cardio, when you're running, when you're moving around all day long. You follow me? Protein is not gonna help you for that. Protein is gonna go straight through your muscle and make you have a force to move around and lift things. And you know what I'm saying? Lift your body and move around and do things that you're supposed to do. But the carb itself is gonna make you last long through the day. The cardio, walk for a long time and whatever. You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah, sweat, whatever you're doing. Now, the thing is, you wanna balance those two. That's the two that I focus on. And I try to have like less sodium, but it doesn't matter to me, man. If I got some water, they say sodium is like, it brings a lot of water in your body. I don't even know what it is. I still need to do research on it. But sodium is in there. Sodium, it is what it is. Like, water in my system, I'm gonna sweat a lot when I'm about to do a lot of push-ups, because I do a lot of push-up and body weight, calisthenic type of workout. So I sweat all that. And once I sweat all that, I'm good. You follow me? I'm good. Like, yeah, so I don't have that problem. Okay, so 10 gram of protein in this boy right here, one of them. 10 gram of protein in one of them. Follow me. And they're pretty small, right? Now, 20, 30, boom, I'm good. 40, I'm never gonna eat four in a straight in the row. But let's say I'm eating three of them. 30 gram of protein is equal to what's on your box, your protein powder thing. You don't need that. All right, boom. I don't wanna mess up people's business out there, but I'm telling you, bro, this food out there is very simple to figure out how to eat healthy and move around and get jacked and work out and have the amount of substance that you need, the amount of protein, the amount of whatever that you need for your body in order to get fit. All right, the video is over, man. Yo, subscribe to the channel, like the video, comment. Don't forget to hit the notification button. And that's what's up. It's your boy TDP. I'm getting jacked. All right, boom. I'm here. I got a six pack ready. I got everything going. I think, yo, this is it. So this is how you're gonna maneuver in order to stay fit, eat well, all right? And you all knows how to cook is even better. It's even better for you because you're gonna make good things out of all those things that I have right here around me. And you're just gonna enjoy. You follow me? I'm on my own, living on my own. I gotta figure out, mama is not gonna cook for me. So I need to figure out how am I gonna do in order to stay fit, cut, you follow me, jack, ripped. I get things rolling for me. So this is what I get. I get food that is already made, right? And I get food that got a certain amount of protein in there, and I make sure I got enough carbs over here and protein mixed with the amount of protein that I really want. Some sodium on the side. I got my carbs together. Sometimes I just go ahead and get like some gallon of orange juice. I didn't do this time, but when you get a gallon of orange juice, what happens is you get enough vitamin C. All right, I think you got like what, 100% or 90% of vitamin C in orange juice. But there is also broccoli. Broccoli got 325, I believe, or even 75. I don't know. I need to make sure. It's got a protein. Broccoli gets 325 gram of Let me Google this thing. I think broccoli carbs is like 29. No, I want vitamin C in broccoli. There is a lot of vitamin C in broccoli. Okay. I thought it was 325 gram of vitamin C or whatever it is, how you call it. Summary, broccoli contains 89 milligram of vitamin C per 100 gram. Huh? I don't know what the hell they're talking about. Vitamin C in broccoli. Okay. Vitamin C, gram. Alright, so summary, broccoli contains 89 milligrams of vitamin C per 100 grams. 1 half cups of steamed broccoli provide 57% of a DV for vitamin C. Okay, what if I say, what if we get the most vitamin C? Look, what if I say vitamin C, broccoli vs orange, vitamin C. Alright, boom, food with more vitamin C than orange starter, broccoli test. This cruciferous veggie provide 132 milligram of vitamin C plus a pinch of fine fiber for just 30 calories per serving, 1 cup. Bro, I don't understand nothing what I'm reading right now. You see, people gonna say, oh, this guy is so smart. You know, this guy is so smart. He knows everything. Now, I don't even know what the hell they were talking about. I'm no nutritionist, man. I'm a computer guy. That's what I do. All right, boom. So all I gotta remember is the protein, the carbs that I look even when I'm at the store. As soon as I pick up something, okay, how much protein they got in there? All right, how much carbs they got in there? All right. Now, when I'm done looking at all this now, on the same list, on every single thing you buy that is food in America, that they have a nutrition fact on it, right here, boom, nutrition fact, everything you buy, they got a nutrition fact on it, and they have a serving size and all that. I wasn't good in math, so when I check the serving size, I gotta do 1 half multiplied by this. I got no idea what the hell it is, so. So I will go with the carbohydrate, the protein, and now on the bottom I will check, okay, what type of vitamin is into this thing. For this, I got vitamin D, okay, 0%. You see, calcium, 17 milligrams. So I try and check, okay, potassium is a lot in bananas and all that, you know. So with this thing, when I start doing this thing over and over and over and over, I start to know, okay, I know there is some iron in this one, but I don't need all that. You see, I just do it for the knowledge. Okay, I think I know what, okay, all right, boom. All right, but I focus more on protein, carbohydrate. And you want to, if you're trying to lose some weight, or you got weight, or you worry about your whatever, you know what I'm saying, your body in a certain way, cholesterol, you want to check that. You want to make sure that thing is zero, of course, and most of the time it's zero. You follow me? Trans fat. Somebody told me trans fat is good and saturated fat is not good. Sometimes you be checking mayonnaise and the saturated fat is like they got some numbers over there, you know. That means you got some bad fat. That was a nutritionist student who told me that the saturated fat is not good. So every time I buy something, even if it's snacks or some stupid stuff, when I check the saturated fat and I see that it's pretty high, I know how much to eat. I know that I shouldn't be eating that thing too much. So eat it just a little bit and just let it go. You follow me? That's something. You gotta check the fat too. When you check the fat, you wanna make sure that the saturated fat is not too much. The trans fat, I think they say it's good fat. So whatever, you can just Google and look for your things. I don't know everything, so this is what I know. This is what I know that I'm telling you. That's how I check my things. I move pretty fast with it. I don't have to go to school and listen to some people buy the program in order to figure out all this complex stuff. No, that's not how I go with it. All right, like the video, subscribe, comment, hit the notification button. It's your boy TDP, and that's what's up. That's how I get jacked. That's how I learn how to do things here and there, and this is what I do. You already know. Hey, subscribe to the channel, and this is the type of video I will be doing. All right, give me a couple likes over here. I don't know how many likes you want to get up to, but you need to get me up to at least something, you know what I'm saying? So I can start, you know, posting video and keep pushing this thing to a certain level, and we're just going to work together. That's what's up. Boom. You want to be in my video? Hit me up.
Hey Mia, TNP, what's up? I'm pulling up. I wanna be in your video, yo. I'm pulling up, yo. I'm pulling up.
Pull up, nigga. Let's do this shit. Boom. I'm out.